If you take the male, gametogenesis process. There are two types of sperms are produced, 22 plus X and 22 plus Y. How many types of gametes are produced? Two types. What are these? Sperms. So here this is called as ovum or simply ova. Sir, if, okay, we can write one because all are same. We can write one because of same number of chromosomes and same type of chromosomes. Here, 22 plus, what happens? 44 plus XX. Now this is female. 22 plus X plus 22 plus Y. That is 44 plus XY. This will develop into male. Sir, here, what is determining the sex? What is determining the sex? The type of sperm. What is the determination of the sex here? Type of sperm. Because 50% of the sperms are with this type of karyotype. One X chromosome, next 22 autosomes. And 50% of the sperms have one Y chromosome and plus 22 autosomes. So here, that is why male is determining the sex. Ova are same. What type of sperm fertilizing the ovum will decide the sex. So what type of sperm is fertilizing? Whether this is fertilizing, that will develop into the female. Well, if this fertilizes, that will develop into the male. Okay. So, but in the society, always females are blamed for the continuous female babies. That is not true. Okay, now, as we have genetics knowledge, females do not play any role in the sex determination process. Tell me, is there any role of female in the sex determination? No. Because all the ova are same. They are homogametic. Mothers are homogametic. All the ova are same. But fathers are heterogametic individuals. Why? Fathers produces two types of sperms. And the sex is determined by the type of sperm. If this sperm is fusing, female. If this Y, 22 plus Y is fertilizing, that will develop into male. So, male is determining the sex. Female is not determining the sex. That is why it is not correct thing blaming the females for continuous female babies. Father is the only reason for the sex determination. And sex is determined at the time of fertilization only. At the time of fertilization only. So, whenever the sexual intercourse is taking place, when this sperm is going towards the ovum, sperms are going towards the ovum, when the sperms fertilizes, then only the sex is determined. At the time of fertilization, the sex is determined. So, this is what heterogametic sex determination. Okay, now, let us see in the form of a chart. So, sex determination, half heterogametic. So, heterogametic sex determination. Okay, now, so heterogametic sex determination is how many types again? Two types. Heterogametic male sex determination. Heterogametic male sex determination. Here, what is another type? Heterogametic female sex determination. Female sex determination. Sir, here this has two types. It has two types. Okay, let us see. What are these? First type is XX, X0 type. Here, XX, XY type. If you write the examples, here, butterflies, grasshoppers, cockroaches. So here, man and drosophila. Human and Drosophila. These are two examples. Okay, now next, heterogametic female sex determination is again how many types? Two types, Z0, ZZ type. Okay, next, ZW, ZZ type. Okay, so here Z0, ZZ type can be seen in Fumia moth. ZW, ZZ type is seen in fishes, boats, reptiles. These are all examples. So this is a chart of heterogametic sex determination. Okay, now. So let us see second type. Sir, heterogametic sex determination we have studied now. And heterogametic sex determination is the first glance. It is the first glance in the sex determination. First discovery, first step in the sex determination. So what is the second type of sex determination? Genic balance theory. Genic balance theory. Okay, now, sir, here genic balance theory, after chromosomal theory of sex determination, what we have learned from the chromosomal theory of sex determination? The chromosomes will decide the sex, or sex chromosomes will decide the sex, isn't it? In the human beings, if Y chromosome is there in the males, that will develop into the male. If both are X chromosomes, that will develop into female. So sex is determined by the chromosomes only. But now, this is not correct always. This is not correct always. Sometimes sex is determined in some other ways. And if you take Drosophila, if you take what? Drosophila. In the Drosophila melanogaster, sex is not determined by the X chromosomes. Sex is not decided by the X chromosomes. So when the Kelvin Bridges, who is this fellow? Kelvin Bridges studied about the genic balance theory. And he denoted that in the Drosophila, sex is not determined by the sex chromosomes. It is determined by the genes which are responsible for the determination of sex present on the A, autosomes, and the number of sets of X chromosomes, number of X chromosomes. Means the sex is determined by the number of X chromosomes by number of autosomes. The genes which are responsible for the male present on the autosomes and the number of X chromosomes will determine the sex. So X by A will determine the sex. Okay, so this is called as sex index ratio. What is this? Sex index ratio. Sex index ratio is nothing but what? Number of X chromosomes. Number of X chromosomes by number of autosomes. Number of autosomes. This is nothing but what? X by A. So X by A will determine the sex.